Firstly, I'd like to welcome Vishal, who'll join us later on stage, who's, friend, collaborator, someone we've worked with for years now on so many different projects, and he's, despite the fact that he had a grueling schedule to do of Rangoon and he was leaving, he still made the time to revive the classic that he and Gulzar Saab had, composed all those many years ago that so many of us have grown up on, and helped us to revive the nostalgia. So he'll be joining us up on stage. But today we've got a really, really special guest as well. When we in India learned that Disney had greenlit The Jungle Book, it was one of those really emotional things for many of us here in Disney India, because it's been a film that so many of us in India have grown up on. We all remember watching the original classic. We all remember, the Bare Necessities and Mowgli and Ka and Bagheera and, Sher Khan, and we've all grown up on those characters. But just the fact that it was going to be done in live action, the fact that it was going to be, given the Disney magic, and the fact that there was going to be a little Indian boy, an Indian-American boy called Neel Sethi, who was going to be playing Mowgli. That, of course, for us was a really big deal, because the fact is, and when I call Neel up, I'll ask him to say a few things about it, is that Neel is actually the only living thing in the film. Technology has grown to the extent today where everything else that's in the movie and that's in the trailers that you've watched and when you finally watch the film is actually not living. He was performing the incredible feat of acting on a soundstage in LA, like he was in the middle of the jungle with all these creatures, but actually acting to blue screen and acting to, the sort of directions from people about who he should be imagining that he's watching. So that's really quite incredible. What we also decided to do was that we wanted to treat the film like an Indian film, in most respects. One is, of course, we've got the English version, but we wanted the other versions, especially the Hindi version, to be one where you actually don't even know that it's a film that's been made for audiences, around the world. Because effectively, you've got Neel playing Mowgli, and all the other characters, once they're voiced by Indian characters, can actually be treated like an Indian film in all respects. So we got Irfan, we got Priyanka, we got Shefali, we got Bugs Bhargav, we got Om Puri, we got some incredible talent on board to voice the different characters in the movie. And when you watch, please do watch both the English version and the Hindi version, and of course the Tamil Telugu version if you know the language. Because the way that we've actually been able to transliterate the language, we've not just translated it, we've actually tried to keep the essence of what was being said on screen intact. And the artists have done a really, really incredible job. And now, I'd like to present our very own Mowgli.
Hello.
Hello. Good to see you. Need a mic.
I got a mic.
Why don't you sit? So Neel, welcome to India.
Thank you.
This isn't your first trip here, right?
No, I've been here like 6 or 7 times.
Okay. Do you have family here in India?
Yes, my grandparents are here, and okay. A lot of my cousins.
Awesome. And what do you like about India the most?
Probably that it's so like different from usual, like just usual New York where I'm from. Mm-hmm. And it's like something that you always have to like.
I heard you have a special fondness for Golgappas.
Yes, definitely.
And how many of them can you put away at one go?
I think I said 27. Yeah, I was trying to beat my sister, but that did not happen.
That's incredible. That, I think, is a feat that any adult in this room would be proud to be able to say they can do.
Yeah.
So, you're here with your parents?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, a big round of applause for them too. Thanks for coming. So, Neel, you are a star here in India already. I think you know that, right?
Yeah, I saw that back there with, like, everything Jungle Book. Yeah, that was pretty cool.
Yeah. So I think everyone here would love to know what the experience was like of working on The Jungle Book.
Well, it was so cool, but different apparently, but because I've never done this before, so I think this is normal, but it's really not. So I just kind of went along with it because I didn't know what to do. John was like, do this. I'm like, okay. Because I don't know what to do, so I just do whatever anybody tells me to do.
So, John, who is a director and who's also directed Iron Man, I heard that there was an interesting way that you guys shot the song Bare Necessities.
Yes.
How did you shoot it?
Well,
because in the movie currently, it's got you sitting on top of Baloo and going down the stream, and that's in the trailer. Mm. But that wasn't really happening, right? Because you guys were on a soundstage in LA.
No.
So how did he get you to shoot that?
Well, that was probably the most real scene we've ever done because it was actual water and an actual water tank. And there was just like a big lump of styrofoam with a fuzzy brown carpet on top that I was just laying on, and John was like the head leaning back. He got into the water, he was just leaning back, and when Blue splashes me, I don't know if that's in the trailer, but oops. It is,
don't worry.
Okay, good. It's really funny because John's actually splashing me and not Blue, and so it was like, he likes to change it up so I don't get bored of whatever we're doing, and it was like something funny. I was like, oh my god, because he actually splashed me, so I actually had a real reaction, and it wasn't acting, so I was just like, splashed him back, because...
So you were actually acting with John and with like sort of the other people on set pretty much all through, mm-hmm. trying to act like they were the characters in the film, right?
Yeah, it was really cool.
What was the audition like?
The audition, okay. I was in a Bhangra class, actually, and...
You were in a Bhangra class?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, Indian Bhangra class.
Does everyone want to see a little Bhangra from Neil? A little bit. Just a step.
I didn't hear this before. No one told me this.
Okay, you guys have to provide the percussion, right?
Well done, well done.
And I heard the first thing you did after your audition was go out and eat a hot dog?
Yes, I did. And that was probably, one of the highlights of that day because I was really hungry and my dad said...
I don't think the Disney executives want to know the highlight of the day you did the audition was eating the hot dog. Okay.
My dad said, if you do good, you could get a hot dog. I was like, okay.
So, anything else you want to share with everyone here? Because they're really looking forward to the movie. Anything you want to tell them about the experience?
I just want to say there's a lot of cameras over there.
Yes, there are.
Like, a lot. It was just really fun and a lot, like, so different, I guess. And I love, like, touring all around the world, especially India, because this is my home.
I heard you've got a line that you don't speak Hindi, of course,
yeah,
because you've been born in the US and grown up there, but your mom's taught you a line in Hindi that I think she'll be thrilled if you can recite for everyone here.
Okay, so I may get it wrong, but it's okay. Okay. Main Mowgli ho, and... Oh, not and.
No, that's that, yeah. But main Mowgli ho was fine. Or?
Main ghar hai. This is my...
Ye mera
ghar hai.
Wow, well done. Okay, on that note, we're going to show you guys the Hindi trailer, followed by the making of, and then a little special something, and then we'll have someone else join us up here on stage. And on that note, I'd like to ask Vishal to come join us up here on stage. Thank you, Vishal. Thank you for recreating a lot of nostalgia for many people in this room and around the country. Please. So Vishal, you want to talk a little bit about the song as it was back then and what it was like doing it now?
Yeah, I think it was year 1992 when it was my first break and I was struggling in Bombay. I just shifted from Delhi. It was year 91 I shifted, and the serial was being made, produced by NFDC at that time. And someone else was supposed to do this song, but at the last moment he backed out and Guldar Saab called me that we have to do a song, but it has to be recorded tomorrow and because it has to go on air day after. So it was a Sunday morning and I went to his place and I played him some tunes and he's a genius master and he wrote this line, Chaddi Pehen Ke Phool Khilaye. And we recorded the song, and the song was released, and then it became like a big success. It was my first big success.
This was your first song?
This was my first song with
first
Guldar
song in Bombay.
And Bombay and with Guldar Saab. And this became a big success. I remember on 26 January, the Ganatantra Divas parade, there was a jhanki which had Chaddi Pehen Ke Phool Khilaye. So it became like a national anthem in those days. And and then my career started. Then Guldar Saab gave me a break in marches. And then, I became a composer and then director. And after 23 years, when Amrita called me and said that we want you to do revive that song again. And the situation was the same because I was going for my Rangoon shooting. And I had only one day to re-record that song. And then Guldar Saab and me, and we met and we did this. And I'm so happy that, it's again being liked by people. And I remember one thing, yes, that when it was released in 1992, a friend of mine called me from Bhopal. He said, the RSS Shakha behind their home, in the morning they sing this song in their morning Chaddi Pehen Ke
Phool Khilaye. Chaddi Pehen Ke Phool Khilaye.
Because
and they moved to long pants now.
Yeah, so. And it was Kamal Kapoor. So, I remember so much, and I thought it's worth mentioning today.
That's incredible. So Neil, it's not a song you ever heard, right? But I heard that your mom heard it when she was in India, isn't that? Yeah, yeah. So it's something that so many people in India have grown up on, and those, like Priyanka was saying, the show that used to come on Sunday mornings. I'd like to open it up to Q&As now. I know that Neil's dying to answer some questions.
Yeah.
And Neil is so cute in the film.
Thank you so much. Vishalji. Vishalji. Yeah. Vishalji. Vishalji, जो ये original song जब आपने बनाया था, तो उसके बोल कुछ अलग थे. और इसमें बदलाव किया गया. हालांकि ये बोल भी बहुत खूबसूरत है, लेकिन ये क्यों चेंज किया गया? उसमें बहुत अच्छे.
मुझे लगा कि 23 साल में हम लोग भी ग्रो करने चाहिए. वी शुड डू समथिंग न्यू. सो दैट वाज द रीजन.
तो ये जो सॉन्ग है, ये भी गुलदार जी ने ही लिखा है?
जी जी जी.
और
इट्स रियली अनफॉर्चुनेट ही कुडंट जॉइन अस टुडे. ही इज sent his wishes to us, and he just got back from Dhaka from a week-long trip, and he said he would have loved to be here.
Siddharth ji, aapse bhi ek sawal karna tha ki ye film bachchon ke liye bani hai, itni badi itni bhavya film, aur wo bhi hamare desh ki film, ise UA certificate diya gaya, to uska aapne virodh kyun nahi kiya? Kyunki ye film hi bachchon ke liye hai, to usko UA certificate kyun diya gaya?
Film to bachcho ke liye hai, there's no doubt about it, but it's also for families. And I think, we wanted to retain the sanctity of the film and ensure that we didn't have to cut the film at all from exactly the way that we would like it to be seen. And unfortunately, I think for a U certificate, we might have had to do that. So I think what we figured is that families will be able to come and watch it, parents and kids will be able to come together and watch it, and we'd like the film to be, kept, exactly as it is. So that's why.
But I have seen the film. There is nothing which asks for a U.S. certificate in this film. It is such a beautiful film. there's nothing which is going to scare kids or
Yep. Nope. It's a kids film through and
but
through.
But let's accept this fact that these are the times that Jungle Book is being given U.A.
Neil, this is a question for you.
Hi.
Out of all the animals that you worked with, which one is your favorite?
Well, I didn't work with the animals, but if I had to
pick, okay.
Yeah, probably Baloo the bear, because he's so free-spirited and laid back, and he cares, but he doesn't want to worry that much, and he's like all bare necessities and all happy, and yay, he's like very calm.
Hi, Neil.
It's pretty amazing. I just before the next question. The reason Neil says he didn't have to work with animals is because he really didn't. This was shot completely on it was shot on blue screen, and everything that you see in the film has actually been added in later. So that's the amazing part about technology.
Hi, Neil. This is Alok on your right. What's the reaction from your school friends after the first promo trailer?
Okay. Well, when I first went for the audition, I was end of elementary school, and our school basically split up into two schools, and all of my good and close friends all went to the same school as mine. And so when I got there, like late sixth grade, everybody knew me, everybody was still comfortable with me, because it was most of the same friends. And some of the new friends, they think it's really cool. Most people think it's really cool, but they still like, they don't realize how big it is. But I'm happy about that.
So do you know about Bollywood and your favorite actor or actresses, if you name?
Huh. Well, I really, like when I watch any like Indian movie or anything, it's just really cool. And it's kind of different. I don't know, just is. And I just really like it.
Hi, Siddharth. Yeah.
Hi.
My question is, how did you go about with the voice casting for the Hindi film, and how important was it to get Nana Patekar as Sher Khan again?
You know, he was our first choice. So, I mean, just how we went about going, how we really went about the voice casting was, we decided that we really wanted to be able to cast known voices in each of these parts, because each of these parts are so well known. We all know Baloo, we know Bagheera, we know Ka, we know Sher Khan, we know King Louie. So we really wanted to be able to get voices that we all recognize and love and enjoy to be able to go with each of these characters. And we made up our list, and we had obviously first choice, second choice, third choice. And thankfully, all our first choices, as soon as we approached them, said that they'd do it, because they all love The Jungle Book. And just for them, like Priyanka was saying, to be able to voice Scar, just the fact that, you know, you've grown up on this character and now you can actually get to be their voice, was something very special for them.
Hi, Siddharth. Siddharth here.
Hi.
Manisha. In the old Jungle Book that we watched as kids, there was another character called Rani, which I don't see in this one. So is the story the same, or is it slightly different from the
If you can just remind me, who was Rani?
Was the girl who comes from where the humans...
So you'll have to watch the film to know whether there is a Rani in this or not.
Okay, my question to Neil. Okay, Neil, now that you're a star, are you treated any differently at home? Do you get kind of a star treatment?
Not at all, not one bit. My sister will still beat me to the ground.
So vehement no, and his parents are nodding. Very vehement no as well.
Especially my sister, she'll beat me to the ground.
Hi, Siddharth. Hi, Siddharth, towards your right.
Hi.
You know, like you said, that Jungle Book, people have grown over Jungle Book in India. So, and since it is a solo release on 8, so what sort of release are you planning for the film in India?
We're planning a very wide release. I don't have the exact number of screens really at this point, but it is going to be English, Hindi, Tamil and Telugu. And it's going to be a very, very wide release across the country, because we think it's a film that's going to appeal to, you know, pretty much, you know, everyone.